Next, we will introduce a new function called arcsin. Let's recall the sine of x function and its graph. And let's answer the following questions. Is this function 1-to-1? The answer is no, because it doesn't pass the horizontal line test. Does this function have an inverse? The answer is also no, because only 1-to-1 functions have inverses. Now, let's make a new function g of x from the sine of x by restricting the domain of the sine function to the closed interval between -π/2 and +π/2. Is this function 1-to-1? Yes, because it passes the horizontal line test. Does this function have an inverse? The answer is also yes, because all 1-to-1 functions have inverse functions, and here's what it looks like. What is this function? This function is not any of the functions that we already know, so we give it a name, arcsine of x. Let's take a look at this new function and its graph. The domain of this function is from -1 to 1 inclusive, and the range of this function is from -π/2 to +π/2 inclusive. We should be able to find the output of this function for any input in the domain using the graph or a calculator. However, the outputs for some nice inputs we should be able to figure out analytically. For example, let's find the value of arcsine of 1/2. We're looking for some value that is between -π/2 and +π/2, such that sine of that value is equal to 1/2. There are infinitely many values for which sine is equal to 1/2. However, only one of them is in the desired interval. Therefore, arcsine of 1/2 is π/6. Let's find arcsine of sine of 7π/4. We're looking for some value that is between -π/2 and +π/2, such that sine of the value is the same as the sine of 7π/4. There are infinitely many values for which sine is equal to sine of 7π/4. However, only one of them is in the desired interval. Therefore, arcsine of sine of 7π/4 is -π/4. We introduced a new function called arcsine and discuss some of its properties.